So this presentation, basically I will just cover roads and highways, preparation of DPR when we go for the design of the project. This is a very vast field. Every slide can be taken for one hour, but I will cover it. I will try to cover all the aspects within a very short time span that you can have a overall grip of the project. This presentation covers these are the things. I will give a brief introduction, what is DPR, why, when it is prepared, then overview of the topic, then basic fundamentals, some major activities for the detailed DPR. And to achieve these major activities in brief, what is the state of art concepts nowadays are taken up, and evolution in the field, because roads and highways is a very vast, from the beginning it is coming long 1,000 years ago, but how it is evaluated in India and now where we stand, it will be there. At the end, I will give a brief journey to the career path and job opportunities. So basically, what is DPR? All these discussions are related to roads and highways field, including structures and all preparation at the detailed design stage. So this is a project report phase that provides summary specification, engineering designs of main and support infrastructures. It also leads to finalization of pre-construction costs like land acquisition, utility, rehabilitation and resettlement, that is R&R. DPR also provides summary of financial aspects, including sustainability, that is which type of package it will come in, ETC or HAM or BOT. Also, this will cover the requirement of statutory clearances and what are the forms to be filled up for forest, wildlife, environmental, etc. So when we are going for the DPR, initially when a project is conceived, first it is going for inception report, then a feasibility report. Feasibility means the project is feasible. By through us various means, it is feasible. After that, DPR steps come up to coming up this proposal. After investment proposal are finalized through feasibility stage, DPR preparation takes place. And here capital cost and other facilities are finalized. Once feasibility of a project is confirmed and approved, it goes for detailed preparation. It is basically further planning and detailed implementation of the project. So who goes for the DPR preparation? Initially, this project is considered by government departments, various governments. Then consultant firms are responsible for preparation of DPR by BD, and this is awarded by the government agencies. There are funded projects like World Bank, ADB, JBIC, Japan Banks, all these funds and funded projects. They need specialist consultants for this DPR preparation, that is mandatory for them. And subsequently, this DPR are engaged by consultancy firms. Then some government agencies are there who prepare DPR by their in-house resources. And these are mainly consultants nowadays are preparing detailed project report for the government. Comes to overview of a topic, that is major stage. Major stage are DPR. DPR is a very vast, I tell you. So before going through preparation of DPR, we divided it into four parts. That is part one, regular deliverables. As per your terms of reference, there are many things mentioned in the reference. I will go to the scope, that is your scope, in the latter part of this presentation. Part two covers the land acquisition formalities, which includes the schedules as per norms and project requirement. Land acquisition is a major aspect in our roads projects here. There are a lot of formalities, like starting from gazette notification, which called small 3A. Then award of this land, that is 3G. In between there are 3 capital A and 3D. Part 3 is preparation of bidding document and committee approval. We need to get approval from the planning review commission. So for that, we need to prepare all schedules and all documents. That is also part of a DPR, detailed project report. And part 4 is project clearances and closure of the services. This project clearances including utility clearances, environmental clearances, forest, wildlife clearances, everything comes under that. So that is also plays a very important role in DPR finalization. As I say that in that earlier slide, that point, the regular deliverables as per TUR, and this TUR is terms of reference, that is the scope of services. This scope of services, there are huge scope of services. If you go through a terms of reference, it is about 20, 30 pages scope of services. So I have summarized few to understand the brief idea of the scope. This is assessment of all reports and information about the road and its influence area, environmental social impact assessment through screening, public consultations, detailed reconnaissance, identification of possible improvement in the existing alignment and bypass, the detailed traffic studies, inventory condition surveys of the road, pavement, all these component of the structures, detailed topographic surveys, and pavement investigations. In addition to that, we need to identify strength of subgrade and source of construction materials, detailed design for roads, is cross-section, horizontal and vertical alignments, identification, the type and design of intersections. It may be interchanges, grade separated intersections are also there. The design of drainage system and disposal point for stormwater, value engineering and project costing. Value engineering is that we can, in that DPR stage, we can give 2-3 options, and which is the economic, most economic option, and which will give an advantage to the client is the value engineering. And from that, we're framing up the project cost. Once cost is finalized, scope covers that contract packaging and implementation schedule, EPC mode or any other modes, then strip plans showing land acquisition, how many trees are felled, clearances, everything. So in a nutshell, preparation of DPR scope covers, preparation of detailed project report, cost estimate, approval for construction drawings, rate analysis, detailed bill of quantities. Detailed bill of quantities means item-wise cost, how much excavation cost, how much pavement cost, quantities like that. Document for execution of civil works, financial and economic analysis. So this scope of work, based on that, if we sum up, the deliverables are this 7 plus next there are 4. Total deliverables are there. So main volume, design report, material report, environmental assessment, including EMP and RAP. EMP means environmental management plan and rehabilitation action plan. Volume 5 is specification, technical specification, rate analysis, cost estimates, bill of quantities. Volume 9 is drawings. 10 is contract agreement, tender documents. Then volume 11 is project clearances. In addition to that, we need to submit land acquisition notification, land acquisition plan schedules. Then schedules A, B, C, D. These are the project specific improvement proposals. A is the existing schedule. B is the proposed schedule. C is the what are the amenities we are providing in the contract. D is where we are departure from the contract. H is the payment schedule for the contractor. These are called EPC projects. Major activities in DPR. So these are the deliverables. I have discussed the scope of work, the deliverables. So to achieve that, what are the major activities we should cover in a DPR? We need to do the inventories of the road, then traffic surveys, pavement study that required bypass or not, tunnel required for the hill station or not. In addition, topographical survey, pavement investigation and characteristics, material investigations, subsoil investigation at bridges. This will give the strength of the ground where the bridge will be casted, so that what type of bridge will be given, it will be understood and finalized by that data. In addition to that, we do environmental and social issues because we need to get clearances from various departments, preparation EIA and ACIA. EIA means environmental impact assessment and social impact assessment. Collect required maps for land acquisition and finalize schedule. Geometric design, pavement design, improvement proposal for roads and bridges, which require flyovers, RODs, etc. Prepare the DPR, prepare BOQ, bill of quantities and cost estimate, prepare various schedules and assist client to finalize bidding documents and getting clearances. This is a long process actually, all these major activities about 6 to 8 months, sometimes small projects give 4 to 6 months. This is a long process. So major activities, if we sum up all those scope of services and major activities, there are 6 steps. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are the 6 steps which we need to carry out for a DPR. In next subsequent slides, I will briefly give these details, what are the covering in these slides on these steps. Step one is review of available document. Consultant collects available data information of the study. This includes actually existing road conditions mainly. What is the subsurface condition? What is the hydrology condition? If there is any existing bridge, what is that condition? Road inventory of the existing road, how it is? What is the climate nearby areas? Then existing geological maps, catchment areas, contour plans, condition of existing river banks, protection works. All those things will count when we'll frame our own development proposal for the project. Details of sanctioning project, because our project may be in between, before and after there may be other projects. So we need to tie up with those projects. So all those details, origin and destination of commodity movement characteristics, historical traffic data, speed delay survey, inventory data, all those are required under the step one, review of data. Then accident data, vehicle loading pattern, type and location of existing utility services, if we go for widening of the road, this existing utility information is very much required. Environmental setting. Step two is the traffic survey and studies. This is the you can say backbone to start with the project, because this traffic, from this traffic surveys, what are the surveys I have mentioned here, from this traffic surveys we will come up with the future traffic, we'll get the growth rate, and we can find out future traffic which will give the configuration of the road. It will be 2-lane or it will be 4-lane or it will be 6-lane with the paved shoulder or without paved shoulder. This traffic survey give that. In addition to that, from the axle load survey, we get the loading, pavement loading details. This loading means million standard axle, how much repetition of axles is coming on a road, so that we can design the pavement based on that. Engineering study and investigations. These are mainly covered on the ground. First, ground reconnaissance has to be done to understand topographical features of the area, typical physical features along the road, possible alignment alternatives. So this reconnaissance is needed to frame up further survey and investigation works. So if we find some realignment requirement, it includes the provision of bypass, what is the traffic pattern if we provide a bypass, primary identification of traffic homogeneous links, who will use this bypass, so those things will be covered up. Then inventory of the major aspects, that is, in the inventory, we need to collect land width, terrain, pavement type, carriageway type, bridges, structures, means type of structures, all covered on the inventory. Then intersection type, urban roads, is it in a geologically sensitive area or not, environmental features are there or not, like that. Required detailed investigations for those critical areas. Type of the extent of the utility services along the alignment within the ROW means right of way, that is the road land available. This engineering survey investigation are done mainly road structures inventory I've already covered. In addition to that, it is their topographical surveys, existing pavement composition assessment. This is BBD. BBD is the Winkelmann beam test or falling away deflectometer test. It assesses the existing pavement strength and overall it needs the this is the existing pavement. Excuse me, I think some cameras are on. Something. This existing pavement thicknesses are there. In addition to that, subgrade assessment, we can understand. Existing CBR, that is existing strength of the pavement, basically. Identification, this engineering survey also covers material sources, lead and strength, suitability of various works, then initial environmental issues, monitoring, then subsoil exploration or geophysical investigations at bridge sites, GPS survey for the identification of, that is ground penetrating radar, GPS survey for mapping and subsurface utilities. Then come the role of design of highway. Here, the role of highway engineer will be very much needed, because he will finalize improvement schemes, geometric design as per terrain, geometric design to be done with based on topographic survey and inventory data. Also, he will finalize various, he will cover in his improvement proposals how to tackle that wildlife areas, environmental sensitive areas, how service road to be provided, where to be provided, all those will cover under design of highway. Then proper care to be taken for settlement, payment design to be done for 20 years or 30 years, 20 years for flexible payment and 30 years for rigid payment, means concrete payments. Geometric design have taken care of widening and approach of narrow bridges and special or signature bridges. Here the role of highway engineer, bridge engineer will play very much. They will decide how much, what is the type of special signature bridge will be there. It comes drainage design based on a method of various methods, that roadside drains, how much culvert size is required, what is the drain requirement, all those things will come. Then sufficient embankment height to be analyzed, HFL, high flood level, high water level to be inquired and proposal to be framed based on that. Design of highway, it covers geometric design, covers horizontal alignment, longitudinal profile. And by this type of cross-sectional element, there is a hill road cross-section I have put here. There will be flat road also. Hill road means one side it is valley, other side it is hill. In valley side, we have breast wall, retaining wall. On valley side, sometimes breast walls and all. That we'll discuss later. Pavement design, it will cover strengthening of the pavement of bypass, and design of the shoulder. All this covers under pavement design. We have various codes. Indian Roads Congress has codes. There are manuals also. this SP84 is the Hill Road, SP73 two-lane manual. All those manuals are there. IRC37 is there for pavement design. All those will be used for this design. Additional design consideration at hill roads. It is especially for the hill roads. Like, we need to get the option for tunnel and various viaduct structures. Then we need identify the fault in rock structure and impact of fault in the design of DPR tunnels. So detailed design of road considering incorporating aspects in hill region, like it needs to cover terrain, topographic condition, extreme weather conditions, all this. In addition to that, design covers protective works, slope stabilization, erosion control, landslide, snow drift control. This is very interesting aspect, snow drift control in ASHTO. The Americans, they have given very detailed analysis of this snow drift control, avalanche protection measures, all those to be covered under highway design. So this is a brief picture that there is a winding road and in hill area. So we can go like this alignment with a small tunnel so that we can bypass this type of alignment and provide a good smooth geometry. Design of highway also covers structures. In structures, actually, I'll not detail it much here. This also depends. Initially, it depends on the alignment, how the alignment will come. If it is a major structure, this major structure will guide the alignment. This GAD, general arrangement drawing, to be prepared, and based on subsoil data, structural design has to be done. So project highway is designed. This is the drainage system design. Drainage system mainly required for the roadside as well as size of the culvert tunnel. Project road highway designed to have well-designed efficient drainage system. While constructing the underpass, the finished road level is determined, ensuring the rainwater does not accumulate there. The drain, however constructed, is provided with proper gradient and connected to the existing outlet for final disposal. So there are erosion control measures like this four, left side four. These are various types of retaining wall. And this is the hillside. In this hillside, we can go the breast wall, and valley side, we can go for retaining wall. Much detailed discussion can be done on that, but right now I will leave it here, just pointing out that these are also part of detailed design. Then traffic safety measures, road furnitures, road markings, those are also to be designed at the detailed design stage. Landscaping is a very important feature in road design. If you travel or see the roads in UAE, Muscat, and European countries, you can find importance of the landscaping for their wide road. It is very soothing journey and smooth journey for that. So this landscaping nowadays is a very important part in our road projects also. In addition to that, nowadays there are designs include toll plaza, weighing station, parking areas, rest areas. Toll plazas, as per there is a Indian Road Congress Code 84, at every 50 kilometer, we need to put weighing station, parking area, and rest area, or we have to put petrol pumps, first aid, medical areas, all those facilities are provided. These are now more or less mandatory for highways projects, and designer need to concentrate, find out places for that during his design operation. Fifth step is environmental and social impact assessment. This is detailed design. When it passes through forest land, when it passes through wildlife, these are very important. So detailed design can be, initially it will be screening, then there will be various environmental impact assessments are there, so those will be taken care. DPR gives special attention to the environmental enhancement measures, cultural property enhancement along highway, by bus bays and bus shelters, including review of their location, highway landscape, enhancement of highway side water bodies, redevelopment of borrowed area located on public land. In social assessment, we need to conduct baseline socioeconomic and census survey to assess the impact on people. Socioeconomic survey will establish the benchmark for monitoring R&R activities, that means rehabilitation and resettlement. It is a very important aspect in places in India, in rural areas. This resettlement and rehabilitation is very important when we go for land acquisitions. Social assessment is conducted for entire project identify mechanism to improve project designs to meet the needs of the different stakeholders. A summary of stakeholder discussions also to be there, to be attached, how the project design, this is the part of our project also. Step six is estimation, economic and financial analysis. This detailed estimate for quantities considering design, asphalt diagram, project cost for entire project, including cost of environmental, social safeguard, all these there. Ministry of Roads and Highways and Transport, MoRTH, has got data book. We use that and the market rate. Detailed analysis for computing the unit rates for different items of works to be done. Unit rate analysis taken into account, including various inputs and basic rates, suggested location of plants, respective lead distances, mechanized construction, etc. So carry out quantity of bitumen, steel, cement likely to be used in the project, where from where to be bring, all those things are covered under estimation and rate analysis chapter. Cost estimate, then it is find out the cost estimate of the project facilities, apply them center charges as per standard norms, like how much supervision will be there, what will be overhead, all those. Find out finally cost estimate excluding land acquisition, then add all those land acquisition, shifting of utilities. Compare this per kilometer TPC is the total project cost. It's given in detail justification for cost. We need to give detailed justification of the cost. Unless we have a good detailed project report, this giving this justification will be very difficult. Nowadays, this justification giving is a very important part at the end of the project before going to the tender. Finally, we need to, based on the cost, we need to finalize the package, construction period, and how much escalation during the construction period we get. This, for that, we need to discuss with the client and finalize the package size and fixing the construction period. Next step is the economic analysis and financial analysis. These two I will not discuss much here because this is the mainly job at the feasibility stage, but in the detail engineering stage, we do it mainly financial analysis, because this cost is, when we do the feasibility, there are a lot of assumptions up there, but in detail engineering, there is no assumptions, all data-based. So we get the actual cost and we can finalize the modality and execution type of the project. That's why this financial analysis is very important at the detail engineering stage. So we can, based on that, we can find VGF, that is viability gap funding, then premium requirement for BOT, then hybrid annuity and EPC. There are the modes of various modes of for this one. The picture which I show in here, table 11.1, it is from a project. Just this looks like how this financial statement comes and how this IRR calculates. To achieve this DPR accurately, nowadays we go for various state of art concept. This is recently launched in last few years. I think 5-6 years it is in. For topographical survey, we are using LIDAR and drone, all satellite-based laser type of system. Then for traffic, we are using ATCC, automatic traffic counter system, video counting. For utility mapping, we are using GPR method. That is, these are all ground penetrating radar. These are all now for the consultancy. They are all inbuilt in that as a terms. So this left one is the GPR. This is the machine we can understand. We can find out the underground utility where it is located. This is the ATCC traffic counter that automatic. This is the strip they fit, and when car truck passes, it counts the number. And this is the LIDAR, and this is the drone pictures. Nowadays, by drone, we can survey the areas very fast. This is pictorial view. That if a drone, how it captures and how laser return back his data. And this is the output of the drone survey, what we get after calculating and processing the data. This itself is a very huge task and separate aspect in the detail engineering project. In addition to that, we have survey investigation for the pavement survey. Nowadays, roughness survey are carried out by NSV. NSV is, I will detail in the next network survey vehicle. In the next slide, I will give in the detail. So this is now mandatory. National Highways has made mandatory use of national survey vehicle to enhance quality of highways. The provision has been included in the bidding document during preparation of DPR. This is now mandatory aspect in a DPR preparation. So NSV, what is gives, why it is given? It is high resolution digital camera for 3600 imageries, record imagery videos at regular interval, laser road profilometer and other related technology to measure distress of road sections. Earlier, which usually we do by visually observations, now we can do by this profilometer and all these imageries, we can analyze correctly. NSV helps to collect data to analyze the road condition, including measurement of road surface, surface cracking, pothole and patches. Apart from that, it provides insight related to side drains, road furniture, etc. This is a just pictorial see of this vehicle. It covers all the details, and we can collect all this data after doing this survey through the NSD. Another part is state of art concept in the erosion control and slide zone management that ensures stability of the road network. It is very important now. So provision of geogrid, gabion wear mesh, soil anchors, rock bolting by wear mesh with boulders extending down to the riverbed, drainage of accumulated rainwater via catch drain, tooth drain, etc. covered. So this is soil nailing, gabion mesh, rock bolting, geogrid. Now specialist companies are there who are doing this with a lot of innovation and a lot of state of art concept. There are many companies in India has come. Few are Swedish, few are Austrian. So they are in India with India company collaboration. They are doing this state of art concept, particularly in hill areas of Uttarakhand and Northeast. In few of my projects, this team are engaged. So they are very specialized in this field. It comes that evolution in the field. See, you have seen that DPR, preparation of DPR, you can now understand that how fast this field is. So development of road system is a continuous process. So come up to this at this level now, this is a continuous process. This process follows several steps: assessment of needs and transport options, planning of system to meet these needs, designing an economically, socially, and environmentally acceptable, robust set of roads, obtaining the required approval and financing, building, operating, and maintaining the system, providing for future extension and reconstruction, strengthening. So these are the process for several steps we need to follow. Then to achieve that goal, road and highway sector had gone through various evolution and through some improved quality of road for commuters and transportation. Modern technologies like IT-enabled systems, like if you can now pass through toll plazas, you are using FASTag. 3-4 years before, it was not that. Advanced implementation of DPR, like remote sensing and LIDAR, that drone we are using. So accurate construction can be done nowadays. Construction machineries are also now laser-based and very accurate. Also to help financing, not only that DPR one. So while doing financing, so evaluation has done in the construction, financing also, financing part. Earlier, there was only BOQ based, that we prepared BOQ, contractor do the BOQ operation. There are a lot of quantity differences and more. So now there are models like BOT, HAM, all these are implemented. Similarly, EPC models are also now prepared. HAM means government will pay some and private party will pay something. In BOT, concessioner will pay. In EPC, milestone basis payments are there. So all these evaluations are going on nowadays. New softwares like MX Road, Inroads, Civil 3D, MIDAS, TAD, all are incorporated for faster and accurate designs. Government initiatives are continuous for way forward of Indian roads highways development. Government also taking own initiative like scheme like PMGSY, like Pradhan Mantri Gramin Sarak Yojana, Bharatmala project, third deep for Northeast roads. These are in place. Development activities are in full swing. Also, processor evolved to faster the pre-construction activities. One of the major issue was land acquisition. So now portals like Bhumirashi has been introduced, which accurately assess land acquisition requirements, which was basic fault are now resolved mostly. So after evolution this, now we can come to our end part of this session, which I will cover little bit career path and where the job opportunities can be for a highway engineer and similar type of engineering. India is one of the fastest growing economy and into an era where infrastructure is the core of the country's economic development. Everybody accepts nowadays that infrastructure is the core of economy. And in this infrastructure, road sector plays the pivotal role. This sector is a critical one in growth of Indian economy, that about 60% of goods are transported by road and nearly 80% to 85% passenger traffic by road. So it is a huge network. But developing is also going in very fast. India is with the 27 kilometer each day. Now we are aiming at 40 kilometer per day and it will be achieved soon. But the main drawback, we are recent time, new bids have been slowed down, that many DPRs have been canceled due to challenge in the bidding process as well as shortcoming in the DPR preparation. Like if we do not assess the cost properly, if we do not assess the development proposals properly, cost assessment will be wrong, then the bidding process will be wrong. if we do not assess the land acquisition properly in detail engineering, then the land acquisition also data will be wrong, so project will halt. So inadequate technical due diligence at the time of preparation of DPR can also lead to cost due to aspect like suboptimal alignment, leading to enhancement in construction cost. So industry is very much focused to have technically sound engineers in their payroll to work in this mammoth infrastructure development target by the government. And it will continue for next so many years. You cannot imagine now, because lot of new projects are coming up in the pipeline, and old projects which are 10 years old now coming for either widening or maintenance part. So paradigm shift is expected from highway construction development for quality service. Earlier only construction was done, now the quality service of highway, because both freight and passenger transport need quality service. They can pay the toll, but they need quality service. Based on the current sector trend, following at the priorities of this sector, stress on operation maintenance and capacity augmentation work, focus on efficiency in freight and transport, passenger transport, priority on road safety, more innovative financing mechanism, eye on sustainable transport approaches. So before going to the next slide, I will just try to give a brief how this job opportunities and our whole system lies. Like a project, project means this is a feasibility, DPR, consultancy services for project management, consultancy, road safety, etc. So these projects, clients and fundings are there to do these projects. Clients are various state governments like NHI, NHIDCL, BRO, MSRDC, state governments, and government funding, multilateral banks, World Banks, ADB, JBIC, etc. there. And who does this project mainly? Consultants, private organization, individuals who performs and delivers the project reports, etc. So this is the project organization in a page. So next slide will be there. There are ample field of opportunity as consultant to prepare DPR, doing PMC as client, or as client doing the jobs in government organization. So in the next, I will give that job opportunities, how, when, where, for from these roads and highways, you can get the job. If you see this chart, there are pre-bid engineering. Pre-bid engineering means before bidding, nowadays EPC contractors want to assess the quantities, how much quantity will be there. So they engage some consultants. So this is a job. Government of India, MoRTH, they offer DPR, detailed project. The state governments offer detailed project reports. Detailed project reports for private players are also there. In EPC, in DOT, they want design director. They call design director. So there is jobs up there. Proof consultancy, after the detailed design, government needs proof consultancy and safety audit. So there we need engineers. Infra projects are there, that SEZ, there township projects are there, special economic zone and townships are there, where roads are there, bridges are there, culverts are there. So for that, road engineers are very much needed. PMC service means project management, construction, supervision and operation maintenance. Private company nowadays ask for project management consultancy. In addition to that, there are standalone bridge projects, tunnel projects, very high cost projects. These are 1 kilometer, one tunnel itself costs about 300. So if it is 3 kilometer tunnel, it itself will be 1,000 crores. In addition to that, lender engineers, that means banks also need engineers. When they give the loans to the contractors, they need assessment of the loan, how these works are going on. So also they need lenders engineers. So if you see, this is a lot of scope in the roads and highways in coming days. We need to grab it at proper time.